Let's do now two exercises related with EMI, electromagnetic induction. Number one is two circular coils. One is of small radius R1. Another is of very large radius R2. Are placed coaxially. Calculate mutual induction. Assuming current in this coil is I1. So, magnetic field due to coil 1, I can say outer coil is 1, inner is 2, B is equal to mu naught I1 over 2R1 at the center. Flux linked with the second coil with coil 2, phi B is equal to BA, that is phi B is equal to mu naught I1 over 2R1 into pi R2 square. This is R2, this will be R1 in our coil. R1 square fine. Compare the result, compare with result, comparing with mutual inductance wala. Phi BS is equal to M21 into I1. Comparing 3 and 4, M21 is equal to mu naught I1 will cancel, pi R1 square divided by 2R2. That will be the answer. Now here EMF of 0.45, simple question. When current is primary is this and this, so use E is equal to minus M di over dt. Even minus M is not required, because minus is not required much because it is the direction of induced EMF. So put E is equal to 0.5 M, current changes from where to where, 5 minus 2 divided by 300 millisecond, 10 raised to the power minus 3. So M comes out 1.15, when you multiply across, divided by 3. So answer is 0.05 Henry. Two more questions. A conducting wire of 100 turns is bound over and near the center of the solenoid of length 100 cm. So what is given? L is 100 cm, that is equal to 1 meter. N1 is 100, N2 is 600. R is 2 cm. What we have to find? Solution. Mutual inductance we have to find, mu naught N1 N2 pi R square over L. L is 1. So straightway substitution, 4 pi 10 raised to the power minus 7, 100 into 600 into pi into 2 into 10 raised to the power minus 2 whole square. So when you solve, this comes out nearly 4416 pi square, fine, and then minus 4 and minus, this is into 6 into 10 raised to the power 4 into 10 raised to the power minus 7 into 10 raised to the power minus 4. This cancels. So when you calculate, it comes out 79.47 into 10 raised to the power minus 5 Henry. Or you can say 7.9 into 10 raised to the power minus 4 Henry. Another question is related to the two conductors coil L1 and L2 solution. Let first case connected in series. I current passes through it. EMF across this is A1, across this is E2. So in series, net EMF is E1 plus E2. And how much is induced EMF in the coil? E is equal to minus LdI over dt. So use this formula. Minus L equivalent di over dt. Current would remain same because it is in series. Di over dt minus L2 di over dt cancels. So L equivalent is equal to L1 plus L2. Result is exactly similar to series combination of resistors. Right? So let's see second case also here. In parallel combination, two coils are connected like this. L1, L2, potential difference same, current will be different. In parallel, I can say total current is I is equal to I1 plus I2. Differentiating with respect to t, di over dt is equal to di1 over dt plus di2 over dt, right? You can get the value of di from formula E is equal to Ldi over dt. So this you can write minus E over L equivalent. This minus E over E is the EMF across this. It is same. L1 minus E over L2. Here we have neglected. Mutual inductance. That might be there, but we are not counting here. So 1 over L equivalent is equal to 1 over L1 plus 1 over L2, that is L1 L2 over that's how again it is similar to parallel combination of resistors. Many more problems you can see. Conceptual problems are also very frequently asked. Let's see. Question number 5, conceptual. This is the coil which is connected with two parallel plates of capacitor. Towards this face, south pole of magnet is moved. Plate A and plate B. From the back side, north pole is moved. What you have to see, what is the polarity of capacitor. Beautiful question. Now, since capacitor is there, in the circuit, so current cannot flow because it blocks DC completely. But this is like this coil, here capacitor is connected, south pole is moved like this. So this pole will be formed south, because south pole is brought closer to the loop. So the direction of current will be in the loop, should be clockwise, but it won't appear kyunki circuit yahan pe toota hua hai. Then this current comes out from plate A, enters in plate B. So the polarity of plate A will be positive, polarity of plate B will be negative. Likewise, question 6, you can check, there is a magnetic field. I can give you two relative questions here. A rectangular coil of a wire ABCD is moving out with constant velocity V, and a circular coil is moving in. I can mark this point A, B. What is the direction of induced current? In a rectangular wireframe and a circular wireframe? Now you see, rectangular wireframe is going out of the magnetic field. So the magnetic flux linked with it will decrease, and when it decreases, then tendency will be to increase according to the Lenz's law. So the direction of induced current will be clockwise. Now, so you can use Fleming's right hand rule. First, find out what is original direction of current. Magnetic field, direction of motion of conductor. So the direction of induced current should be this. But this is, it should be anti-clockwise. But if this loop is moved outside the magnetic field, so according to Lenz's law, it reverses the direction of the current. So it will be a clockwise. So what is the direction of electric current here? Induced current A, B, C, D, A. This kind of loop will be formed. This is getting in again, same way you can work out, you can choose element here. Magnetic field here, conductor is moving here. So direction of current is A to B. Since it is entering, A to B means it is anti-clockwise. Magnetic flux is increasing, so it is anti-clockwise, right? But you have to reverse the direction in the case when it is moving out. Question 7. There is a coil, inductor coil, attached with a battery and key in the same line of this. There is a ring placed with center coinciding. This is a copper ring. Question is, what happened with the ring? What will happen with ring? Nothing, it will move. How? Now question arises, where will it move? See, the direction of current in the coil is like this. So in the turn it is moving like this. This is, what is the direction? Clockwise. So this side of the solenoid or coil, this inductor coil behaves as south pole. The copper ring kept here, magnetic flux linked with the copper ring changes, so it also develops south pole in order to oppose the magnetic flux linked with it increasing, right? So there will be a repulsive force. Eventually the copper ring will move away from its position. Or you can, in short, you can say when current is switched on in the coil, the pole, magnetic pole formed on the face of the coil will be same as induced on the copper ring, and there is a force of repulsion between two identical poles. So copper moves away from the coil.